teleporter. Doesn't anyone want a teleporter? I mean, I grab these objects and it almost told me what to create this piece. This is actually a frame of a children's sink. It was just like a pine box, and then I slowly sort of built it up and built the pieces into it and branded it the teleporter. Yep.
If you could be teleported somewhere, anywhere in the universe, in space and time, where would you go?
I think I'd go and hang out with Hendrix. Golden rose, the color of the dream I live. Not too long. And then maybe back, you know, to the 17th century, go and check that out. I would say I'm a big lover of that period because I think back then they were really strong on integrity, authenticity, and product was made to last back then. And to me, I think in the modern world, we've lost a little bit of that. And I think with the machines, there's a little bit of romanticism in sort of bringing that period back to life and putting it in the future. They're made from found objects, and some of them sort of laid dormant for a little while I found objects to finish the final touches. I suppose they were inspired by puzzle making, really. I just looked at certain parts and, you know, found solutions within merging them together and, yeah, created these machines. Junkyards, the side of the road, waste stations, yeah.
Hard rubbish.
Yeah, hard rubbish.
Hard rubbish.
Yeah. There's an element where the works are sort of static, and then there's an element where, you know, you can interact and sort of play with, you know, pulleys and switches and things like that. So there's an element of imagination to the machines, for you to explore the machines. My approach to life changed through making these machines. I think the complexity of such works has allowed me to have a simplicity in life. Because I get to sit quiet for long periods of time, I find a quiet within myself. I think I'm a living dreamer. I tend to have a thought and then go and do it. I think probably the most exciting thing is creating something out of nothing or something out of a throwaway. Yeah, and seeing the finished. I hope some eccentric buys them. That's what I really would love to see happen with the Dream Machines.